elements of the experimental mice. And this venture induction of urethrin was successfully prevented by and was repeated to the animals by Ashwagandha. So this was the first evidence that this previous plant medicine is effective in preventing cancer, chemically induced cancer in lungs. There we also try to find out the mechanism underlying this anti-cancer activity of Ashwagandha. There we found that this Ashwagandha has an immunostimulant effect, and it increases the number of white blood cells, that is leukocytosis, in the blood of those animals treated with Ashwagandha. So, this immunostimulant activity can also be helpful in the treatment of COVID-19. And so that it can be added with the already protocol treatment along with this, and people can also take it by preventing COVID infection by taking 1/4 teaspoonful daily. But we have to take care that Ashwagandha has to be at least root fiber. Already the fiber of the root is affected, and other parts of the plant, such as the stem, leaves, juice, experimentally have agreed for the first time 50 years ago that this drug is helpful. As this drug is also being marketed in the Indian market as a Bhaktaraka tonic. It is possible that those who consumed Ashwagandha in old days might have been saved from the development of cancer in old days, and incidence of cancer might have been low, both persons who have taken Ashwagandha. But the previous 100 years ago, Ayurveda and Ajahnani system of medicine prevalent in India, and in those times, the incidence of cancer was also low. And people have taken this Ashwagandha. It is also one of the ingredients of Jampas, but the quantity added in the Jampas is very, very low. I'm not sure whether it has any clinical efficacy, but for that part, we have to take 1/4 teaspoon or 1 gram of Ashwagandha root fiber daily, mixed with honey or a syrup of cane sugar. So now coming on to the present COVID-19 pandemic, I have suggested a medicine that can prevent and as well as treat COVID-19 successfully and